माइनॉरिटी वर्ग से आते हैं, 80 पर वही एक ही बात होती है। देखो भैया, आप आपके बीच में और हमारे बीच में एक बात आप समझ लो, आप लोग सब कुछ जानते हो और आप लोग कभी जिंदगी में गलती नहीं करते हो। हम लोग गलती करते हैं, हम लोगों की सुनते हैं, हम सब कुछ जानते नहीं है, हम सीखते हैं। ये फर्क है हम में और आप में, एक तरफ गांधी दूसरे तरफ सावरकर। एक हिंसा का प्रयोग करता है, दूसरे अहिंसा का।
बैठो बैठो यार, बैठो बैठो बैठो।
भाई ही सिंगल
प्लीज,
भाई ही सिंगल सिट डाउन, भाई ही सिंगल
नो, बैठो बैठो,
तू रोक लेगा प्लीज, प्रेजेंटिंग द
हाउस, लेट द मेंबर्स टू स्पीक। अरे यू आल्सो सिट डाउन यार, आप लोग भी बैठो, बैठो बैठो,
देन नोबडी विल
स्पीक। बैठो बैठो, अब आपको लगी, अब आप लोगों को नमक लगी।
भैया एक बात बताओ, एक बात सुनो सुनो, मैं एक बात समझ नहीं रहा हूँ। स्पीकर सर, चेयरमैन साहब,
प्लीज प्लीज ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स, प्लीज प्लीज टेक योर सीट मेंबर, प्लीज टेक योर सीट प्लीज।
चेयरमैन सर,
आई विल गो थ्रू द रिकॉर्ड, आई विल से आई विल गो थ्रू द रिकॉर्ड, प्लीज प्लीज बी सीटेड, लेट इट लेट द मेंबर टू स्पीक।
No, please. Let the member to speak. Please, I will go to the record. Yeah. Please.
मैं बात समझा नहीं। अच्छा बोलने दो।
Please, I do.
अरे भाई सुनो तो, अरे भाई।
अरे उत्तेजित क्या हो रहे हैं यार?
Please, I do to the chair. Please.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, चावल रात।
सर 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 सर
क्या मुझे चेयरमैन सर, चेयरमैन सर मुझे बात सर, चेयरमैन सर,
आई विल गो थ्रू द रिकॉर्ड्स एंड टेक अ डिसीजन, प्लीज लेट द मेंबर टू स्पीक।
चेयरमैन सर
प्लीज,
मैं एक बात समझा नहीं, मैंने सिर्फ एक बात कही, गांधी हमारे हैं, सावरकर आपके, क्या इसमें कोई गलत बात कही मैंने? क्या सावरकर आपके नहीं है क्या? क्या आपने उनको उठा के फेंक दिया? क्या सावरकर को आपने फेंक दिया, उठा के फेंक दिया?
आप जवाब दो, जवाब दो।
अरे जवाब दीजिए, सावरकर को आपने फेंक दिया क्या? उठा के फेंक दिया, बाहर कर दिया? क्योंकि अगर आपने किया तो बहुत अच्छा किया। अच्छा अब भाषण बोलने दीजिए मुझे
जी, राहुल जी प्लीज एड्रेस टू द चेयर, प्लीज एड्रेस टू द चेयर, प्लीज कंटिन्यू।
40% स्टूडेंट्स, 40% जेएनयू के स्टूडेंट्स के माता पिता की आमदनी 6,000 रुपए महीने से कम है। आप जेएनयू और रोहित वेमुला के पीछे क्यों पड़े हैं मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूं, क्योंकि वह गरीब है, क्योंकि वह कमजोर है, क्योंकि वह दलित है, क्योंकि वह आदिवासी है, और आप चाहते हो कि हिंदुस्तान में गरीब वर्ग, आदिवासी वर्ग आगे ना बढ़े, पीछे का पीछा रहे, पीछे का पीछे रहे, और हम ये नहीं होने देंगे। आप ना जेएनयू को कुचल पाओगे,
जस्ट मिनट,
ना इस देश के गरीब लोगों को।
वन मिनट, ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स प्लीज डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब द मेंबर व्हाइल स्पीकिंग, इफ एनीथिंग यू कैन स्पीक व्हाइल योर टर्न।
Thank you, Chairman, sir.
Please come.
I thank you very much. आखिरी बात थोड़ी सी मैं अपने धर्म के बारे में भी बोलना चाहता हूं। हमारे धर्म में कहां लिखा है कि अध्यापकों को और शिक्षकों की पिटाई करी जानी चाहिए? आप मुझे दिखाइए कौन सी किताब में लिखा है कि कोर्ट में जेएनयू के अध्यापकों को, टीचर्स को, स्टूडेंट्स को पीटा जाना चाहिए मीडिया के सामने? और आप मुझे बताइए प्रधान मीडिया को भी मारा। और मैं सवाल पूछना चाहता हूं प्रधानमंत्री जी से, जब मीडिया को मारा गया, जब अध्यापकों को मारा गया, स्टूडेंट्स को मारा गया, तो आपने एक शब्द क्यों नहीं कहा? चेयरमैन सर, आई'd लाइक टू स्पीक अ लिटिल बिट इन इंग्लिश फॉर माय फ्रेंड्स इन द साउथ। अगर आप चाहते हैं, अगर आप चाहते हैं, अगर आप खुश नहीं हैं, तो इसको बाद में मैं हिंदी में आपके लिए फिर से कह दूंगा। ए नेशन इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन इट्स पीपल, इट इज नथिंग बट द कॉन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन इट्स सिटीजन्स। डिस्ट्रॉय द रिलेशनशिप्स, Stop the conversation and the nation dies. अच्छी बात बोली, आपको अच्छी लगी तो ऐसे थोड़ा मार दीजिए हाथ, आप थोड़ा सा मार दीजिए, मार दीजिए, एक बार मार दीजिए, क्यों कष्ट हो रहा है आपको? अगर अच्छी लगी मार दीजिए,
अच्छी नहीं लगी अच्छी लगी।
स्पीकर मैडम, when Sorry. Chairman sir, when I salute the flag, I am not saluting the cloth. I am saluting the relationships that the flag represents. A Muslim man who joins his Hindu brothers to play holi, or a Hindu man who embraces his Muslim brothers on Eid, a Christian woman who bows her head when she walks past a Gurdwara, a Jat farmer who embraces a Dalit laborer in Haryana, a Punjabi student who protects his brother hailing from the Northeast. The relationship between Rohit and his fellow students, the relationship between all of us on this side of the aisle and those of you friends sitting across it. When I protect the flag, I protect the conversations on which those relationships are built. I protect every single voice, and I pay special attention to the weakest, those voices that are most difficult to hear, that nobody can hear. Respecting the flag means respecting the opinion of every Indian. When I went to JNU, your ABVP workers waved black flags in my face. They taunted me and they abused me.
Shame.
To my face.
Shame. Shame.
I felt no anger. In fact, I felt proud that I still lived in a country, in an India, where it was possible for me to be confronted by people who held a different opinion than my own. I don't agree with their views. I protected our Indian flag when I let your people wave those black flags in my face. I protected the Indian flag when I allowed them to taunt me. You cannot defend the Indian flag by destroying the relationships between our people. You are not defending the flag when you frighten your own people into silence. Whose opinion does the Prime Minister listen to? Whose opinion does he respect? Does he respect your opinion? No. Does he respect the opinion of his ministers?
No.
You're in silence. I understand. And I understand the feeling within you And I want to bring that out. I want you to make him listen. But anyway, that will happen slowly. You have been taught by your teachers in the RSS that there is only one truth in the universe. You have been taught by your teachers in the RSS that there is only one truth in the universe, your own. That nobody else's opinion matters. That nobody else's opinion matters in the entire universe. This is all you have shown us in the last 2 years. The Prime Minister cannot run the country on only his opinion. The country is not the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister is not the country. One day, the Prime Minister called all the senior opposition leaders and told them he had achieved what the Congress Party couldn't achieve in 40 years. He told the Congress president that he had solved the Nagaland problem. He had solved the Nagaland problem. And he had signed a historic accord. Congress president panicked. She panicked. She called me up. She said, Rahul, what have they signed? Our chief ministers have not mentioned anything. She asked us to check with our chief ministers. We called them up. We asked them, have you heard about the Naga Accord? As my esteemed colleagues know, the Naga Accord has huge ramifications for the states of Arunachal, Assam, and Manipur. Massive tracts of land in these states are involved. We called them. They had not heard a word about the accord. What had the government signed? I'm coming to that, my friends. What had the government signed? They asked us. According to the media, even the officials in the Home Ministry and the Intelligence Bureau had no idea. Even the Home Minister had no idea. Fascinating. I'm asking a straightforward question. Did the Home Minister know about the accord? Did the Nagaland Chief Minister know about the accord? Did you tell our chief ministers about the accord? And the most important question, where has this accord gone now?
Yeah.
It has vanished into thin air. Poof, it's gone. Gone with the wind. Bye-bye, accord. We see you tomorrow. Is it not an insult to every citizen of those states? Is it not an insult to the institutions and professionals in the Home Ministry and the Intelligence Bureau? Is it not an insult to the Indian flag? Pakistan directly attacked this country in Mumbai on 26/11. They trained and sent killers, murderers into Mumbai, into the heart of Mumbai. Almost 200 people were murdered and butchered by those people. I am coming to that, my friends. The operation to stop the terrorists was on. Our soldiers and citizens were dying. The government of India begged the Chief Minister of Gujarat not to go to Mumbai. The then Chief Minister of Gujarat decided to go to Mumbai. Did he care? No. He went right ahead to Mumbai, to the Oberoi Hotel itself, and disturbed the entire operation. He grabbed his headlines while our people died.
Very shame.
Shame.
But let us forget that. Mumbai was a horrible, terrible blow to this country. It was a blow to every single Indian. The UPA government worked tirelessly to trap Pakistan. We isolated them internationally. We spent thousands and thousands of hours of diplomacy to turn them into a pariah nation. We destroyed their reputation internationally. We destroyed their nation in their reputation internationally and put them into a little diplomatic cage. Yes. We trapped them in a cage this big. Yes. We convinced the world that they were a global supporter of terrorism. How did we achieve this? Speaker, sir. Please.
Please be silent. Let the member to continue. Please, sir. Member, please.
Speaker, sir, how did we achieve this? Our Prime Minister took the advice of everybody. The armed forces, our diplomats, our intelligence people. We had wide-ranging conversations with everybody who understands these issues. We spoke to the opposition. We utilized the great talent and expertise that is available to this country. We worked tirelessly in Jammu and Kashmir, and I must tell you, it is the work that we did there, that the UPA did there, that makes us all really proud. We held panchayat elections. We built thousands of self-help groups and created thousands of jobs. Main Hindi mein translation de dunga aapke liye. By the end, we had destroyed the insurgency in Kashmir. We had broken the back of the insurgency in Kashmir. The biggest strategic victory had been achieved against Pakistan completely peacefully. What does the Prime Minister do? He decides to have a cup of tea with Nawaz Sharif. He decides that I am going to go and have a cup of tea with Nawaz Sharif. Without any thought, without any vision. Without any thought, without any vision, he decides to take a detour to
Pakistan.
Please,
you can make your submissions when your turn comes, please. Let the member
without
speak.
Any thought, without please, any vision, he decides to take a detour to Pakistan. Just like he did with the Nagaland Accord. He did not bother to ask anyone. He did not bother to ask the armed forces. He didn't ask the intelligence people, not even the diplomats. He probably did not even ask Sushma ji. He just went there as if only his opinion matters. Speaker, sir, the Prime Minister single-handedly destroyed 6 years of our work. In one move, he personally let Pakistan out of the little cage into which we had put them. He gifted them a status equal to our own. When he stopped over at Pakistan without talking to the professionals in our government, the Prime Minister disrespected our flag. He disrespected those who died in Mumbai and in Pathankot. He disrespected the talent of our bureaucrats. He disrespected the tremendous talent of the Indian people. There have been others in history who could only see their own perspective. People who saluted the cloth but destroyed the relationships and conversation between their people. Milosevic, the president of Yugoslavia, used to salute the flag every morning and talk of patriotism all day long. He broke the relationship between Serbs and Croats and destroyed his country. Nearer to us, Yahya Khan claimed to defend the Pakistani flag. As a soldier, he used to salute their flag every morning. He actually believed he was protecting it. He thought he was a patriot and refused to listen to his countrymen. He destroyed the relationship between Punjabi and Bengali. and he tore his country into two. The Prime Minister still has the option to listen to what the country is trying to tell him. The country is gently trying to give him a message. The Prime Minister just has to listen to the message. Listen to those around you. Listen to Rajnath Singh ji. Listen to Advani ji. Listen to Sushma Swaraj ji. Listen. Wo yahan hai nahi, magar mera bhashan sunenge. Listen to your MPs. Listen to us across the aisle here. We are not your enemies. We don't hate you. Listen to the voice of the Indian people. Listen to the farmers and workers who have so much wisdom. Especially listen to the voice of the next generation. They are the future of this country. Allow them the dignity of their voice. Thank you.
Sri Honorable Member Prahlad Joshi ji. Patel ji, you can make a submission later on. Let the member to speak.
Sir, thank you for this opportunity. मेरे भाषण से पहले राहुल जी का भाषण हो गया. ये राष्ट्रपति अभिभाषण में बोल रहे थे, ये सार्वजनिक सभा में बोल रहे थे, ये तो मुझे पता नहीं चल गया. और ये भी पता नहीं जो लिख के दिया है ना,